Hi, I'm Steve Jones and I'm going to tell you how long it takes to distill water. Now, first of all, let's consider something that we have in our house all the time, an electric kettle. And in fact, although this looks quite complicated and mathematical, all it is about an electric kettle, something household like that. 1 litre or 1.5 pints is the normal capacity of an electric kettle. And 20 Celsius is normal room temperature. So if you want to boil a kettle, you want to raise its temperature to 100 Celsius. That means you're raising it by 80 degrees Celsius, right? 20 from 100, 80. So that is the rise in temperature. And we know that it takes 4,200 joules of energy to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water by 1 degree Celsius. So by 80 degrees Celsius, it takes 80 times as much. In fact, it takes this amount, 336,000 joules. Okay, now we've got the water boiling, but it isn't distilled yet. To distill water, we have a different problem. We're turning it into steam. We're turning water into steam, right? We're vaporizing it. And believe it or not, this takes a lot of energy. In fact, for every kilogram, and of course it happens at 100 degrees Celsius, there's no rise in temperature, but for every kilogram, we need 3.36 million joules. In fact, this is 10 times as much as it takes to raise it to boiling point. So, a rough rule of thumb. It might take 5 minutes to boil your kettle, probably more like 2 minutes. In which case, it will take 10 times as long to turn it into steam or to distill it, which is the same thing. When we distill water, we turn it into steam and then condense it back to water. Therefore, just think, it takes 10 times as much energy to distill water as it does to boil it.